Very good morning, children. Let us continue with the topic. In the last class, you had learned about the sequence when a n value was given, but n value was not given. Correct? A in the last term value was given, but n value they did not give. At that time, how are you going to solve the problem you learned? Similar way, we have two more sums based on that type only. So let us start with those type. That is, the fourth question is over. We are going to solve the fifth question. Correct? So let me solve the fifth question. What does the fifth question tells you? Find the number of terms in each of the following APs. APs, in the sense, they have given two sums. In that, you are going to find number of terms. Number of term and n find out maarbeku, you are going to find n value. You need to remember what all the things that the formula include. Okay, so number of terms, in the sense, you are going to find the n value. Two sums are given. One sum I'll do, one sum you are going to do. First sum is very easy, so you are going to do those sum. You are going to do the first sum. The first sum is 7, 13, 19. It goes on up to 205. So try the things in your rough notebook. Whatever the homework sums I give, try it in your rough notebook and then compare your answers with the PDF what you get and then write it in the homework book. Okay? Now, let me teach you about the second sum. That is 18, 15, 1 by 2, 13. It goes on up to minus 47. Okay? Now, this is the sequence given. Now, let us solve the given sequence. Solution 18, 15, 1 by 2, 13. It goes on up to minus 47. So, let me number the terms A1, A2, A3, and the last term is taken as AN. Correct? You do not know N value. Since AN is given, we are going to apply the formula. An is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. Looking at the formula, what are you going to write? What are the things given? An value is given? Yes. What is the value of an? Minus 47. Then a. A is also called as a1, which is equal to 18. Then n value, you do not know. Common difference, we know the formula, that is a2 minus a1. Here, A2 is in the mixed fraction form. We are going to convert it into proper form. So, A2 is equal to 15, 1 by 2. How are you going to form it in the proper form? As in the last class we saw, you are going to multiply the whole number to the denominator and add 1 in the numerator. So, 15 twos are 15. How much 15 twos are what, children? 30. 30 plus 1 is 31 by 2. So, you have it as 31 by 2 minus 18. So, you have an unknown number. So that is the different numbers in the denominator. So, you are going to multiply the numbers to 31 minus 18. 2s are 8, 2s are 16. 1 carry 8, 1, 2 1s are 2 plus 1, 3. So, it is 36. Correct? Now, you are going to subtract. Which is the greater number? 36 is the greater number. So, you are going to put minus sign. 31 minus 36 is how much, children? 5 by 2. So, what is the common difference you got? Minus 5 by 2. Let me check for the another pair. So, D is equal to A3 minus A2. So, what is the value of A3? 13 minus. What is the value of A2? A2 is in the mixed fraction. You have converted into a proper fraction. So, it is D1 by 31 by 2. Now, since the denominators are different, you are going to multiply the denominator. 13 twos are, it is 26 minus 31. So, what is the value? Which is the greater number? 31 is the greater number. So, minus. So, then 6 plus, how much is 10? 4. 4 plus 1, 10 plus 1 is 11. So, it is 6. 26 plus 5 is 31. So, you get minus 5 divided by 2. Common difference is same for both the pairs of number. So now let me put substitute everything in the formula and find out the value of n. What is the value of an? It is minus 47 is equal. What is the value of a? A is nothing but a1, which is equal to 18. Then n, I do not know. Let me keep it as it is. Minus 1 also. Then what is the value of b? Minus 5 by 2. Now what are you going to do? You are going to multiply inside the bracket. So if you multiply inside the brackets, 47 is equal to 18. Plus into minus is minus 5 by 2 n. Then minus into minus is plus 1 into 5 by 2 is 5 by 2 itself. Correct? Now, what are the constants you have? 18 and 5 by 2. So now, let me take it in the working column. 18 plus 5 by 2. Different numbers in the denominator. Take the LCM. 18 2s are how much? 18 2s are 36 only. Correct? 2 8s are 16. 1 carry 2 1s are 2 plus 1 3. 36 plus 5. 36 plus 5 is 6 plus 4 is 10. 10 plus 1 is 11. So it is 41 divided by 2. So what you get? Minus 47 is equal to 41 divided by 2 minus 5 by 2 n. So let me take this 41 to the left hand side. If I take this 41 to the left hand side, what happens, children? It becomes plus. Or you can take this minus 5 by 2 to the left hand side and get this minus 47 to the right hand side. It is your choice, children. So let me take the constant to the left hand side. So I get minus 47 minus 41 divided by 2 is equal to minus 5 by 2 n. Now different terms in the denominator, multiply. So what you get? 2 in the denominator, 2 7s are 14, 2 4s are 8 plus 1 is 9, minus 49, minus 94, minus 41, which is equal to minus 5 by 2 n, which implies, see the student, the sign tells you, which implies the next step. You can put this and tell it is a next step, okay? Which implies, since you have negative signs, you are going to add and put which sign? Minus sign. So minus 4 plus 1 is 5. 9 plus 1 is 10. 10 plus 3 is 13. Divided by 2, which is equal to minus 5 by 2 n. Please do not cancel this here itself, because even this side you have minus 5 by 2 itself. So do not cancel, since 2 will be going in. 135 will be going in. 2 on the assumption, do not cancel it. Okay, if you have fractions on both the sides, in the left hand side and the right hand side, please do not cancel it, children. So you have, what are the values you have? Minus 135 divided by 2 is equal to minus 5 by 2 n. So let me bring this 5 by 2 this side. While bringing this 5 by 2, let me take step by step. If I take this denominator to the left hand side, what happens? Denominator becomes numerator. Numerator becomes denominator. Correct? Reverse. Numerator becomes denominator. Denominator becomes numerator. So it is minus 35 by 2 into 2 by 5. You can put this minus sign below or above. It is your choice, because since we are doing it subdivision, we can put the minus sign in the numerator, okay? This minus sign will be in the numerator itself. This minus sign includes for numerator as well as the denominator. Aita minus 5 by 2 on the helado. Minus 5 and 2 on the helala. This minus is belonging to both 5 and 2. You can write minus 2 by 5 also. So minus minus 2 gets cancelled. And 5 ones are 5, 2s are 10, 5 7s are 35. So minus into minus will become what, children? Plus. So it is plus 27 is the value of n. And one thing is, the value of n won't be negative. Negative barala, fraction barala, decimal barala. It will always be a whole number. Okay, remember, children, n value won't be negative. Idu always whole number. It will be always whole number. Whole number does not have negative. Correct. In the number system only I told whole numbers does not have negative numbers. It does not have decimal. It does not have fractions. The whole number is a complete whole number with only the positive values. Even the hen will be only with the positive values, the to the whole number. Okay, it can also be zero. It can also be zero, but you are not able to get the negative n value or decimal n values, fraction n values. Clear about this? So I hope the second sum is clearly understood by you. Okay, then nothing, children. If you hear the mixed fraction was there, so the process become lengthy. When the fraction where numbers will be given, the process will be lengthy because you need to take LCM and all. When only the whole numbers or the subtraction symbols will be given, then it will be very easy to solve. You won't feel any difficulty. Okay, then coming to the sixth question. What did you learn in the fifth question? You learned that n value won't be negative, it won't be whole number, it won't be fractions, it won't be decimal, it will always be a whole number itself, correct? Then coming to the sixth question, what does the sixth question tell? Let us see. Check whether minus 150 is a term of the arithmetic progression. What they have told? Check whether minus 150 arithmetic progression na kotti last alone number kotre illa. If they ask minus 150 is a term in arithmetic progression 11852. If this is the question, ee tara question kotrunu, you are going to take the number as a n itself. Artha aagta idya? This number, if they give you the arithmetic progression and ask, check whether or is 1 minus 150 is an arithmetic progression, is an arithmetic progression, or check whether minus 150 is an arithmetic progression. Athara enadru kotrunu, the highest number, whatever they give, it is an an only. Okay, you are not going to take it as separate. It is an value ne. Okay, at the last, instead of giving at the last, as it was in the first question and the fourth question, they have given it in the first initial itself. Then also you are going to take it in the last. Okay, help me number the terms. A1, A2, A3, A4, it goes on up to An. So, what, since you have got An, what is the formula? An is equal to A plus N minus 1 into B. Now, looking at the formula, you are going to write An is equal to the value of An, minus 1 by 5. A is nothing but A1, A1 and A, which is equal to 11. N value, you know? No, children. Then D, well, how are you going to find out D? A minus A, 2 minus 1. So A2 is what? 8 minus 11. So which is the greater number? 11. 11 has good sign, minus sign. So 8 minus 11 is how much, children? 8 plus 2 is 10. 10 plus 1 is 11. So it is 3. Then D is equal to A minus A. After 2 it is 3. After 1 it is 2. A2 is how much? 5 minus 8. 5 minus 8 is also 3. Then you do it here itself. When you get two pairs as same, then you can do it here itself. That is 2 minus 5. 2 minus 5 is also minus 3. So D value got as minus 3. Then substitute in the formula. When you substitute in the formula, what you get? Let us see. You get the value of N. So, what is the value of An? Minus 105 and A value 11 plus N minus 1 and D value is minus 3. Now, what are you going to do? You are going to multiply inside. Minus 105 is equal to 11. Minus into plus is minus 3 and minus into minus is plus 3. So, it is minus 105 is equal to constants 3 and 11. So, 3 plus 11 is 14 minus 3n. Let me bring this 14 this side. So minus 105 minus 14 is equal to minus 3n. 5 plus 4 is 9. 1, 1. is equal to minus 3. And since you have minus minus, you get cancelled, you will be left with this. So let me take it afterwards. Bring this minus 3n to the left hand side. Multiplied with n. Minus 3n is multiplied with n. When multiplication is brought to the other hand, it becomes division. So minus 119 divided by minus 3 is equal to n. So 3 1s are 3. 3 3s are 9. Like left out is 2. 3. How much are? 3 3s are 9, 10, 11, 2, 29. 29 is 3, 7s are 3, 9s are 27. 27, 28, 29. Again, 2 point, if you keep it becomes 20. 2, 6 are. So this 3, 6 are 18. Again, it goes on. 6, 6, 6. It comes as a recurring number. Okay, it goes on recurring. So you got the value as 39.66. Is 39, do you get any n value with the decimal number, children? Yes, what did we conclude? We won't get any numbers with the decimal value. So what are you going to conclude? You are going to conclude that minus 105, 150 is not a term in the arithmetic progression. Why is it not a term in the arithmetic progression? Because you won't get n value in the decimal number. Okay, if they ask you why, in the question, then only you are going to write that n value won't be the decimal number. If they won't ask you why, you are just going to conclude that minus 150 is not the term in the arithmetic progression. Is it clear, children? I have already told you in the last question, that is the fifth question, that whole number, n value will only be a whole number. It won't be a negative, neither the fraction nor the decimal. It will always be a whole number. Correct? So I think the sixth sum is understood for you. Let us go with the next sum. Check, children, check, work out the problems. If you have doubt, come and ask. I always tell you in each and every class that you have doubt, write everything in a sheet of paper and get it to me. I'll help you in solving the problems. Okay. Now, what is the seventh question tells you? No, we are in seventh question. Find the 31st term of an arithmetic progression whose 11th term is 38 and 16th term is 73. Before solving the 7th question, let us solve the 5th example. Example number 5. Because it is easier to understand with the less numbers. So, example number 5. E.g. number 5. So, determine the arithmetic progression whose 3rd term is 5 and 7th term is 7th term is 9. Okay, so what they have given, you need to determine the arithmetic progression. Determine the arithmetic progression, antane you need to form a sequence. So let me keep that aside. Okay, now the question is this one. 3rd term is 5, 7th term is 9. If they give you in this form, in the wordings form, how you come to know? The first thing is, if they give you A3 is equal to 5 and A7 is equal to 9. This question can also be given as this. Okay, if A3 is equal to 5 and A7 is equal to 9, find A10. Question might be like that also. They can twist the question and give. This question can be either in two forms. One, the wording form, that is the 3rd term is 5, 7th term is 9, or they can give you A3 is equal to 5 and A7 is equal to 9. Okay, ER type alle barad. ER type bittu bere type al barad illa. Inta sammo. Now, you came to know how the question will be coming with this, how the question will be framed in this type of question, this type of sum. Now, okay, how to solve this type of sum? Now, what if they have given in the wordings or in the numbers? Let our thing is, we need to write the things what they have given. A3 is equal to 5, then A7 is equal to 9. Correct? How are you going to write A3? How are you going to write A3? For example, let me take it in this here itself. In the general form, that is, you do not know. You are not able to remember the general form of an arithmetic progression, that is A plus B, A plus 2D. You forgot. Now, what will you do? Now, it is A3. Then, A3 is equal to A value gotilla. This N value, you know, what is N? 3. 3 minus 1 into D. So, you got A plus 3 minus 1 is 2D. So, A3 can be written as what, children? A plus 2D. Correct? So, let me write it here. A plus 2D is equal to 5. Aita, then how to calculate A7? Similar way, 7. 7 minus 1 is 6. So 7 will be A plus 6D is equal to 9. Yeah, now you have got it in the general form. Do you remember the missing terms that we did it in third main? Missing terms now, then pitkonidra, that is the elimination method. We are going to take the two equations, cancel the like terms. Then we are going to find out another one term. Similar way you are going to do here also. That is, you are going to take A plus 6D is equal to 9. A plus 2D is equal to 5. Correct? Now what is the next step? You are going to change the sign of the equation, the last equation. It is not a rule, children. First idna tagobeko, second idna tagobeko. No, it is not a rule. It is your choice. Whichever you want, you can take. Okay? Now, 1a minus 1a, it gets cancelled. A term vanished. 6 minus 2 is 4b. 9 minus 5 is 4. So the value of d is 4 by 4, which you get as 1. Why did I take this equation before? Because the numbers what you have in this equation is greater than this equation. Correct? So I took it as first. I do not want to struggle with negative signs. ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ? ದೊಡ್ಡ ನಂಬರ್ ಯಾವ್ದಿದೆ ಅದನ್ನೇ ತಗೊಳ್ಳಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಈಕ್ವೇಶನ್ ಅಂತ. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ನಂಗೆ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಜೊತೆ ಸ್ಟ್ರಗಲ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ ಇಷ್ಟ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್, ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್? ನಥಿಂಗ್. ಆ ಸೇಮ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್, ಬಟ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಸೈನ್. ದಟ್ಸ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಸೈನ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್. ಸೋ 2 ಮೈನಸ್ 6 ಇಸ್ ಮೈನಸ್ 4d ಅಂಡ್ 5 ಮೈನಸ್ 9 ಇಸ್ ಮೈನಸ್ 4d. ಮೈನಸ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್. ಸೋ d ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 4 ಬೈ 4, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ Same you will get, but you will get the negative sign. Now you got to know d value. What is the d value, children? D value is 1. Correct? D value is 1. Now you need to find a value. But now to find a value, take the least numbers. That is a plus 2d is equal to 5. A plus, what is the d value? 1 is equal to 5. Substituting d in equation 1. Substituting d in equation number 2. You need to write. Okay, fine. A is equal to 5 minus 2. A is equal to 2. So, a value you got, d value you got. Now, what they have asked? They have asked you to determine the arithmetic progression. How are you determining the arithmetic progression? A1, A2, A3. A 4. Okay, 4 terms enough. So what is A1? A1 is always the value of A. Then how are you going to write A2? A2 is A plus B. So 3 plus 1 is 4. A3 is A plus 2D. For this you need to add 1. So 4 plus 1 is 5. Check whether A3 is 5. Yeah, A3 they have only given it as 5. Then 5 plus 1 is, so the arithmetic progression is 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes, did you understand, children? Is it easier to understand if this type of question has been given for you? Yeah. So similarly, the 7th question which is there in your exercise. Similar question, not even a change is there. Similar question you have in the exercise 1.2. So let me solve that. Why I'm doing the example sums and the exercise sums? Because I want you to be perfect in the sum. One sum alle ella arthagala. You won't be able to understand in the first, very first sum only. If I do two sums of the similar kind only, you will be able to understand. For that only I'm doing. Okay? And take the seventh question as homework as well as you need to do it in the homework book also. The seventh question, this would be written in homework also. Why? Because you have only one question of this type. I want this to be written in your homework book as well. Find the 31st term of an arithmetic progression whose 11th term is 39 and the 16th term is 73. So you have to find what term you need to find? 31st term you need to find. What they have given, 11th term and 16th term. Okay, then coming back to the solution. Next, what they have given, A11 is equal to 38. Okay, then A16 is equal to 73. Then what else they have given, A31 should be found out. Correct? So let me write it in the general form. How I want to write A11 in general form? A plus n minus 1. 11 minus 1 is 10. 10d, which is equal to 38. Okay. Then how am I going to write 16? 16 minus 1 will be 15d, which is equal to 73. Then how am I going to write 31? A plus 30d is equal to question mark. Clear? Now everything is fixed. Now what are you going to do? You need to find this. Let me keep it aside because it is the last one. Let me take these two equations. Now this is the bigger number. So let me take this as the first and then this as the second. A plus 15D is equal to 73. A plus 10D is equal to 38. Minus, minus, minus. Correct? Now subtract. Minus 1 plus 1 is 0. 15 minus 10 is 5d, which is equal to 3. 3 minus 8, no, 3 cannot be subtracted. So this becomes 6 and this becomes 13. So 8 plus 2 is 10. 10 plus 3 is 13. So it is 5. 6 minus 3 is 3 itself. So d is equal to 35 by 5. 5 ones are 5. 7s are 35. So the d value what you get is 7. Correct? Check. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 5. 5 and 35. That's it. Now you got d. So substitute in equation number 1 or equation number 2. A plus 10 into 7, which is equal to 38. So a is equal to 7. 7 into 10, 70 is equal to 38. So A is equal to minus 70 plus 38. A is equal to minus 10 minus 8, 2, 6 minus 3, 3. So the value of A is minus 32. The value of A is minus 32. So you got A value and D value. Now we are going to substitute in the equation number 3, that is A plus 30d. So if you substitute in equation number 3, what you get? 32 minus 32 plus 30 into 7 minus 32 plus 7 zeros are 0, 7 threes are 21. So it is 210 minus 32. 10 minus 2 is 8. 20 minus 3 is 17. Correct? 20 minus 3 is 17. So you got it as 178. A31 value is 178. Did you understand, children? I hope the sum is very easy to you because you had learned two sums of this type, correct? So I feel this will be very easily understood for you, this type of question. Nothing, children, you are going to see which term is given, write those in the term formula, that is A11, A16, A31. Then you are going to write it in the general form, not in the general equation, general form if you write. So you get A minus 10D, A minus 5, 15D, A minus 30D. How did you get this? Their N value is given, 11. 11 minus 1 is 10, so 10D. Then 16 minus 1 is 15, so you get 15D. 30 minus 1 is 31 minus 1 is 30, so you get 30D. Then you are going to do it in the elimination method as we have did it in the third main. Similarly, 1 minus 1, then the above equation will be changed to the negative signs. So you sign, you change the negative symbols, then you are going to cancel it, and then whatever the value of D you get, you are going to substitute in one of the equation, you get A value. Equation, where is the equation, ma'am? I'll take this as equation number 2 and equation number 3. So you are going to take substitute in one of the equation. So you get the value of A. Then you are going to substitute back in A plus 30D to find out A31. Okay. Is it easier? Yes. Very good. Then coming to the next one. Let me take example number 6. Okay, let me take example number 6. What is example number 6? Example number 6 is same as sixth sum of your exercise. Check whether 103 is the term of the list of numbers 5, 11, 17, 23. So take example number 6 as homework. Take example number 6 as homework. I'll solve and show you how it is. As you have did it in the sixth question in the exercise part, it will be easier for you to do the example. So example number 5, check whether example number 5 is homework. It should be written in homework book. Example number 6. It should be written in homework. Check. Copy this question, children. Since you do not have the textbook, example sums will not be given in the PDF form. So copy this question. Check whether 301 is a term of the list of numbers, that is 5, 11, 17, 23. It goes on. So they have given you a highest number, that is 301. What are you going to take the 301 as? A2, A3 you will take it as? No, you are going to take it as AN. Why? Because it is a very big number which will be taken in the last. So, it is AN. Solution 5, 11, 17, 23 goes on up to 301. Then number sequence A1, A2, A3, A4. AN. Since AN you have got, you are going to write the AN formula. AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. Looking at the formula, you are going to write the things what you wanted. What is the value of AN? It is 301. A they have given? Yes. A which is equal to A1 which is equal to 5. Then N value they have given? No. D you need to find, that is A2 minus A1 11 minus 5. 5 plus 5 is 10, 10 plus 1 is 11, so it is 6. D is equal to A3 minus A2. So 17 minus 11, 1 minus 7 minus 1 is also 6. 1 minus 1 is 0. Then 23 minus 7 is also 6. So you got d value as 6. Then substitute everything in the equation. So you get 301 is equal to a value as 5 plus n. You need to find d is 6. So it is 301 is equal to 5. Multiply inside plus 6n minus 6. So 301 is equal to constant plus 5 minus 6 will be minus 1 plus 6n. Minus 1, if that goes that side, it becomes plus 1 to 6n. So it is 302 is equal to 6n. N is equal to 302 divided by 6. 6 ones are 6, 6 fives are 30. You have 2. 2 won't go. Point 20 you get 6. 2s are 6. 3s are 18. Again you get 2. It will be a recurring number. So what did you get? What did you get, children? It is 5.3. Is 5.3 n value? Is 5.3 an n value? No, the 5.3 is not an n value. Why? Because n should be a positive integer. Here you have got it as in the decimal form. Clear? Is this clear, children? Yeah. Now, in today's class, you have studied about two types of questions where the n value, the same thing last class, what did you learn? That is the n value, a n value will be given, n value you need to find. And then another thing you learned is when they give you everything in terms of words, how are you going to write it in terms in the term? That is, if they give you 11th term is dash, 15th term is dash, now then how are you going to write? A11 is equal to something, A15 is equal to something, then you are going to find the AP or the number what they are asked. Okay, I hope these two types of sums are clear for you. Then in the next class, we are going to start with the different types of sums. Okay, thank you very much, children. Have a good day.